And now we would like to invite to the microphone the father of the bride, Mr. Carl Jenkins.
Hello, everyone. I'd like my son to join me. I'm glad you all sat down, because this gonna take a minute. See, what I'd like for all of you to know is that over these past few years, we've had talks like this. And I deserve this talk, this last and first talk to occur today. So, talk amongst yourselves. Join in. Break forms.
Yeah. Make sure it's right for you.
How you doing? Feel pretty good, huh?
You look great.
Yeah. Let's keep it that way. Well, son, you know, like I said, this is just one of those times when I reserve this last call to share some things with you that I've reserved for some time. You have expressed yourself quite admirably. I know you love my daughter. I know my daughter loves you. That's a good thing. Come on, ain't you? All the tricks of the trade, so you can
and everybody, none of that stuff on there, right? Okay, so I just made that up. He did see it. Son, Bo, you got it. Okay, Omar, you just missed out.
Come on, man.
But no, honestly, I've thought about this for quite some time, and I've had an opportunity to sit back and think long and hard, and from our conversations over the past week, I've just been thinking about, as you said, how this whole thing progressed. And so I'm going to take you back, 1981, August 22nd. What happened on that day?
This day that my mother would say that's her birthday and my birthday.
Absolutely. August 22nd, 1981, your mother gave birth to you. And like every parent, we pray for 10 fingers, 10 toes, sight, just a healthy child. That's the year we call promise. Because you have all the promise in front of you, everything that is set before you, if you work hard, you can achieve, like you work towards getting my daughter.
That was a lot of work.
A lot of work. Years later, your 13th birthday, that's the year of accountability. That's when you become accountable for knowing right and wrong. God holds you accountable for that. Years after that, August 22nd, 2000, that would have been your 21st birthday. And on your 21st birthday, they would more or less say that you were leaving, right? And most would say that's when you become a man. But it wasn't until August 18th when you became a man. You see, August 18th, 2012 was when you made a choice before God and these witnesses I'm going to win this bet before God and these witnesses that your life becomes sacred. And everything that occurs from this moment on, you do for your family, your wife, and if God allows, your children, that's when you become a man. When you realize that your purpose has now been fulfilled. What was taken from Adam was a rib of formed woman. In that rib was everything God needed, but it came from Adam. Today, that rib was returned to you. This is no mistake. This is no mistake. Everything that her mother and I prayed for has happened. Right up to the sun shining on us today. When I say everything we've prayed for, we've received. It is up to you to continue to do what you know is right, to always look for the ways to resolve the issue. No matter how hard, God holds you accountable for the success of your marriage, for your family, for your children. That's a big hill, but it's one that you have accepted, one that you have graciously accepted. You have won the hearts of everyone in my family. How'd you do that? Yeah. But the one thing I would have to say is that my heart is overjoyed. This was just a formality for me. I said to one of your family members, you've been my son for quite some time. You just had to make it official. Now, as your father, I could not let on like the women over there. Because it's my job to be hard. My job to stay hard. Because I have great expectations. You see, I've watched you. I've watched you closely. And I've watched what you do when no one's looking. And I've always told you from day one, you can tell me anything. But it's what you show me that counts. And you've shown me to be the man that I had hoped would marry my daughter. So, there's a lot on you. Azakina?
Yes.
Would you come here, please? Thomas Ryer, would you come here, please? Bo. Would you come here, please? In a couple of weeks, standing on the side of him. Mekorn, come here, please. That's okay. Because everyone's laughing away in the socials. I'm sure the purpose is lost out there. In a couple of weeks, my wife and I will celebrate our 31st wedding anniversary. Yeah. 31 years does not come easy. There are going to be many challenges that you will face over the years. And what you will need to help you get through those challenges are men of integrity. Men who stand at your side and help you through those times. These are such men. I know them each. I've come to know Azakiwe, and I love this man. I know why he loves you. Bo is my son. Tom, my brother. Daquan, my brother. I place these men around you. They have orders. They have instructions. Those instructions are simply to stand at his side, to be truthful with him at all times. When he needs to talk, listen. Be there for him. Three of you are married. All right, speak those things. But be there for him. Because when it was my turn, I had men such as yourself who are still at my side. It is important that you stand by him. I'm his father, and I will always be here. As we say, I got you six. That means I got your back, no matter what. But you need to have quality around you at all times. That is what I've placed in my daughter's life. That's what I hope you will place in yours. Everybody, This is my son. I'm really that big. In whom I am well pleased. You cut the grass when you get back. Left in my home for the past month and a half. You cut that grass.
There's nothing new.
Yeah. All right. That's my choice.